Good morning, girls. In this session, Transportation in Plants and Circulation in Animals, Part 2, we shall discuss about transpiration, blood pressure, uptake of minerals, translocation of mineral ions and sugars, and ascent of sap. The roots of the plants absorb water and transport to stem and leaves. We are quite surprised how this continuous flow of water from the roots to the leaves is possible. Is it not? It is because of the process called transpiration and the pressure created due to it onto the surface of the leaves. What is transpiration? It's a process in which there is loss of water in the form of water vapor from the stomatal opening. Transpiration has both beneficial and harmful effects, and so it is referred as a necessary evil. The opening found on the leaf is called stomata. They are guarded by kidney or bean-shaped cells. They are called guard cells. The stomata are open in the day and closed at night. The opening and closing of the stomata is due to the change in turgidity of the guard cells. So when the stoma are opened, water enters into the guard cell and they become turgid. When they are closed, the guard cell lose water and becomes flaccid. When water evaporates through the open stomata, the water concentration gets lower in the mesophyll cells. As a result, more water is drawn into the cells from the xylem of the leaves through the process called osmosis. As a result, water is lost from the leaves and a pressure is created at the top to pull more water from the xylem to the mesophyll cells. This process is called transpiration pull. As a result, it is very sure that there will be a continuous flow of water from the roots to the leaves. You can try this experiment. It's an interesting experiment to prove transpiration. Cover a branch of a tree with a transparent cover. Leave it undisturbed for half an hour. You infer water droplets inside the cover. It's because the water vapors has condensed to form water drops. This proves transpiration. So if you're interested, you can do this and get the inference to prove transpiration. Transpiration is affected by several external factors such as temperature, light, humidity and wind speed, and internal factors such as number of stomata, percentage of open stomata, water status of the plants, canopy structure. Transpiration. It cools the surface of the leaves and keeps the cells turgid and maintains the shape. Next is the root pressure. In transportation in plants, water movement is a passive transport and movement of ions is an active transport. As we know, ions are charged particles. Due to transpiration or the water loss, an osmotic pressure is created in the xylem vessels. This osmotic pressure, since it is created in the root, we call it as root pressure. The root pressure helps to push water to certain heights. The quantity of water moving upwards through the xylem by root pressure is comparatively low. Root pressure plays a major role in the transportation where transpiration rate is low. Next is the uptake of minerals. During the uptake of minerals from soil, all the minerals cannot be passively absorbed. It is because of two factors. The first one, minerals are present in the soil as charged particles. and so cannot move across cell membranes. The second thing is the concentration of the minerals in the soil is usually low than the concentration of minerals in the root. Therefore, most minerals enter the root by active absorption, and this needs energy in the form of ATP. Remobilization of minerals from older dying leaves to younger leaves enhances translocation of mineral ions. This phenomenon can be seen in deciduous plants. Elements like phosphorus, sulfur, nitrogen and potassium are easily mobilized, while elements like calcium are not remobilized. Wood is synthesized in the green parts of the plant, that is the leaves. The non-green parts are dependent on the photosynthetic cells for nourishment. The photosynthetic part usually acts as a source, and the part in which the food is stored acts as a sink. The food in the form of sucrose is transported by the phloem. This is phloem transport. Sometimes when the leaves shed, the sugar stored in the roots mobilizes the organic material towards the growing buds. Thus, the direction of the source and the sink is reversed. It is bidirectional. The direction we call it as bidirectional, whereas in xylem it is unidirectional. So the transportation of organic solutes from one part of the plant to the other through phloem sieve tubes is called translocation of organic solvent. The mechanism of translocation of sugars is by pressure flow hypothesis. The glucose is converted into sucrose. The sucrose moves into the companion cells, then into the living phloem tube by active transport. This process produces a hypertonic condition in the phloem. Water in the adjacent xylem moves into the phloem by osmosis. By active transport, sucrose moves into the cells where it is utilized or stored. The upward movement of water and minerals from roots to different parts of plants is called ascent of sap. And the number of factors play a role in ascent of sap, and it takes place with the following factors. Thank you, girls. See you next class. Have a nice day.